Okay. So what is meant by plasmolysis? So this is the shrinkage of protoplast in the cell due to the elimination of water. Okay. So whenever a cell is placed in hypertonic solution, very, very important. Okay. Right. So whenever cell is placed in hypertonic solution, so the elimination of water from cell to surrounding is takes place. Okay, which is also called as exosmosis. Okay, so loss of water from cell to surrounding. Okay, right. So in the last class, we have studied very clearly. For example, so this is the plant cell, right? So this is the plasma membrane which is present below the cell wall. Okay, right. So this is the vacuole. So this is the cytoplasm. Okay, so very, very important. In the very beginning, so due to the movement of water from cell to surrounding, plasma membrane, it gets separate. From cell wall at their corners, Tell me, so particularly this phenomenon is known as incipient plasmolysis. Okay, very clear. Incipient plasmolysis. So incipient plasmolysis means separation of protoplast along with the plasma membrane at the cell corners. Okay, which is called as incipient plasmolysis. Okay, right. Now cell is kept, so cell is left in hypertonic solution for more time. So this is the hypertonic solution. So whenever a cell is placed in a hypertonic solution for more time, complete shrinkage of protoplast is takes place. Okay, yes, we have already studied. Due to the elimination of water, so water movement from cytoplasm to surrounding first, then vacuole to cytoplasm. Okay, finally, this is the shrunken, contracted protoplast. So this is the vacuole. Okay, this is the nucleus. So this is the plasma membrane. Okay, right. So we have already discussed about this. Okay, name the substance which is present in between cell wall and plasma membrane. Yes, hypertonic solution. So hypertonic solution is present. In between cell wall and shrunken protoplast. So this is the space which is filled with hypertonic solution, but not water. Okay, so what is the reason? Cell wall, which is not barrier for hypertonic solution. That's why outer solution, so external solution, it enters the cell. So that is the reason hypertonic solution is present in between cell wall and shrunken protoplast. Okay, right, very clear. Listen to me carefully. So when a normal plant cell, which is placed in hypertonic solution, then cell becomes flaccid. Very, very important word. Note this point. So whenever a normal plant cell is placed in hypertonic solution, cell becomes flaccid. Okay, so this is the flaccid plant cell, right, in which pressure potential psi p is equal to zero. Okay, option the chapakurdu, so zero and chapali. Psi p, pressure potential is zero. So what is meant by pressure potential? There is no outward pressure in the cell. But cell lo manaku outward pressure undadu kabatti pressure potential is zero. Okay, right. So that is the reason in plasmolyzed cell or flaccid cell, psi w is equal to psi s. Psi w is equal to psi s and chapali. Okay na, right. Yes. So in the last class, we have already discussed about this phenomenon, that is plasmolysis. Okay, now cell is said to be plasmolyzed cell. Plasmolyzed cell and chapane. Okay, na? Tell me, in plasmolyzed cell, psi W very low. Next, psi S, nothing but solute concentration, is very high. Okay, right. So in which psi P, pressure potential, zero. Okay, right. So wall pressure, write down, very, very important. Wall pressure, also zero. So what is meant by wall pressure? So whenever pressure potential is present in the cell, for example, this is the cell. Okay, the pressure is exerted by protoplasm in outward direction. Okay, this is pressure potential, but here pressure potential is zero. Okay, so whenever pressure potential is present in the cell, then wall, cell wall, it exhibits inward pressure towards cytoplasm or protoplasm. And the pressure potential outward ga unte, okay, in the opposite direction, wall pressure, it exhibits inward pressure. That is wall pressure. Okay, so whenever pressure potential is present, then wall pressure also present. But here pressure potential is zero, that's why wall pressure is also zero. So these are the conditions in plasmolyzed cell. Okay, na? Right. So when cell becomes plasmolyzed or flexed, when it is possible due to exosmosis. So exosmosis means elimination of water into surrounding from cell. So that is exosmosis. Okay, right. Come to next one. So I already told you, plasmolysis, it does not take place naturally in living organisms, in living systems. Okay, it does not take place naturally in living organisms. Okay, but in some instances, like, write down, extreme. So extreme water stress. Extreme water stress. So this is the condition. Or salinity. Salinity. Under extreme salt conditions or extreme water stress. Okay, these are the possible exemptions. Okay. So under these conditions, plasmolysis is takes place. So plasmolysis already observed cheyachu. Okay. Yes. In the last class, we have already discussed about practical applications of plasmolysis. Very, very important. Okay. So what are the practical applications of plasmolysis? Preservation of pickles by adding salt. Okay, na? Generally, manam pickles ku salt add chesinappudu salt concentration ekku untundi kabatti, so solute concentration ekku untundi kabatti, so bacteria or fungal spores are unable to grow or survive. Okay, so under high salt conditions. Okay, so that's why preservation of salt, number one. Next, so preservation of fish and meat in the salt, also another good practical, okay, so application. So preservation, okay, na, manu already man cheppam. So meeru pickles ku salt add chesaru ankonde, for example, this is a bacterial cell. Okay, so under high salt concentration, it undergoes plasmolysis that results in the shrinkage of protoplast, then bacterial cell gets killed. Okay, so unable to survive in the pickles. Idi ikkada manam clear ga mention cheyochu. Right, come to next one. Isotonic solution. Isotonic solution. Take isotonic solution. For example, so this is the external solution. External solution, right? So this is the plant cell. So plant cell, right? So this is the plasma membrane. Right? So this is the vacuole. And this is the cytoplasm or protoplasm. Okay? So this is the nucleus. Okay? First of all, what is meant by isotonic solution? The concentration of external solution balances osmotic pressure of this cytoplasm. Write down. The concentration of external solution balances osmotic pressure of the cytoplasm. So that means in both external solution and in the cytoplasm, water potential remains same, osmotic potential remains same. So that is the reason there is no net movement of water from surrounding to cell or cell to surrounding. Okay, so that is the reason. Write down. Net flow of water is zero. So whenever cell is placed in isotonic solution, okay, so here the conditions are isotonic. These are isotonic conditions. Okay, simple ga cheppalante, so water potential in the external solution and water potential in the cytoplasm remain same. That's why net flow of water is zero in either direction, from surrounding to cell or cell to surrounding. Okay, right? So these are equilibrium in state. So equilibrium state lo unnai. Okay, so that is the behavior of cell or tissues in isotonic solution. Okay, is over. Next, come to another one. Hypotonic solution. Okay, listen to me carefully. This is the plasmolyzed cell. Okay, in which this is the shrunken protoplast. So this is the plasma membrane, right? So this is the vacuole, right? So this is the cytoplasm. Now plasmolyzed cell is placed in hypotonic solution. So this is the hypotonic solution. Tell me, so what is the behavior of cell? Okay, so this is the hypotonic solution. Okay, it is very clear. So water potential of external solution is much greater than cytoplasm. Listen to me carefully. Water potential of external solution is much greater than cytoplasm. Or solute concentration is very low in external solution and which is much greater in cytoplasm. Which one? Solute potential. But water potential? Low. So this is the plasmolyzed cell. Okay? Whenever it is placed in hypotonic solution, then water moves from surrounding to cell. So as a result of this, along with the plasma membrane, enlarges in size. So this is the plasma membrane. Okay, so this is the large vacuole. Okay, right. So this is the cytoplasm. Due to the entry of water from surrounding, So from external solution. So protoplasm or protoplast, it enlarges in the size. Okay. And finally, it exerts pressure. It exerts pressure towards outside. That means on the cell wall. Okay. This pressure can be seen in the cytoplasm is called as Turgor pressure. Okay. So Turgor pressure. Write down. So due to the entry of water into the cytoplasm, it makes the cell wall, cytoplasm in which a pressure builds up in the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm lo pressure build up avutundi. It is an outward pressure towards cell wall and it exerts more and more pressure on the cell wall. Okay, this pressure is known as Turgor pressure. Okay, in other words, which is called as pressure potential. Deene mana pressure potential, okay, or psi p denoted by symbol psi p ani chupistunnam. Okay, Turgor pressure also denoted as tp for Turgor pressure. Okay, malli cheptunna definition ikkada, listen to be carefully. So pressure potential or Turgor pressure, this is the pressure exerted by protoplast due to the entry of water from surrounding to cell against cell wall. Okay, it is very clear. Listen to me carefully. The pressure which is exerted by protoplast or cytoplasm on the cell wall, against cell wall, nothing but outward pressure due to the entry of water, that is important. Okay, so due to the entry of water, okay, which is called as pressure potential or Turgor pressure. Okay, yes, it is also an important point. Whenever Turgor pressure or pressure potential is present in the cell, then wall pressure also present in such cells. So wall pressure, it is an inward pressure exerted by cell wall onto the cytoplasm. And a protoplasm ila outward push chestunte, in the opposite direction cell wall inward pressure exhibit chestuntundi. Okay, so pressure potential unte wall pressure kuda unnadi. Okay na? Yes. Finally, whenever plasmolyzed cell is placed in hypotonic solution, it becomes turgid, that means more swollen. Maga swell up avutundi cell. Okay, this is a more swollen cell. Okay, tell me, so this is deplasmolyzed cell. Note this point. Okay, this is the deplasmolyzed cell, nothing but turgid cell. So turgid cell. Okay, in turgid cell, water potential is equal to, okay, psi s plus psi p. Okay, not only osmotic potential, not only solid potential, pressure potential also present in the cell. That's why psi w is equal to psi s plus psi p. Okay, na? Psi s plus psi p. And chapali mana. Okay, na? Right. Write down. What is the importance of Turgor pressure in the cell, which is responsible for, write down, which is responsible for extension and enlargement. So extension and enlargement of cell and useful for cell growth. Cell growth kuda use avutundi endukante cell swell up ayante, so that means cell growth takes place. Okay, so that is the importance of Thurgar pressure, right? Now, write down. So now it is very clear. Plasmolysis. Okay, plasmolysis is a reversible process. Reversible process. So whenever plasmolyzed cell is placed in hypotonic solution, cell which takes water. Okay, so that's why it becomes deplasmolysis. Okay, but a deplasmolysis, it is an exosmosis. Whereas deplasmolysis, nothing but endosmosis due to the entry of water into the cell. Cell lopaliki water enter avutundi kabatti danni mana deplasmolysis nu endosmosis ani kuda cheppochu anamata. Okay, right. So listen to me. For example, an animal cell. So whenever animal cell is placed in hypotonic solution, then what happens? Is it burst? Ippudu meer animal cell teeskoni hypotonic solution unchar ankonde, ippudu animal cell evala burst avutunda? Yes. Okay, right. So reason, due to the lack of cell wall. So whenever animal cell is placed, write down, whenever animal cell is placed in hypotonic solution, it takes water and gets rupture or burst. So burst out of the, but plant cell does not burst. So what is the reason? Rigid and tough cell wall is present around the cell. That's why it does not ruptures, okay, and bursts due to the presence of hard, okay, so thick cell wall is present. Okay, it is very clear. Next, tell me, other than plant cell, so name the other organisms having cell walls. Bacteria, cyanobacteria, and fungi also having cell wall. Okay, that's why they do not burst whenever these cells are placed in hypotonic solution. But animal cell is placed in hypotonic solution, which takes water and gets burst, ruptures. Okay, so due to the lack of cell wall. Okay, so very, very important. Next, but not given in our textbook, write down. Diffusion, pressure, deficit. Okay, abbreviated as DPD. Very, very important. DPD. Okay, so what is meant by DPD? Write down. In the reduction of movement of water in a solution, so that is DPD. For example, listen to me. So it is a 5 grams of sucrose solution. 5 grams. Next, So another one, it containing 10 grams of sucrose solution. So this is, it contains 10 grams of sucrose solution. Tell me, in which one? For example, this is the A, this is the B. So in which one solute concentration is very high? In which? So in which psi S is very high? Okay, solute potential or osmotic potential is very high, but in which solute concentration is low? Sir, you could clearly tell me, it is a 5 grams of sucrose solution, this is the 10 grams of sucrose solution. Okay, in the first one, solutes are very less when compared to second one. Okay, at the same time, in which number of free water molecules is very high in the first one. So deentho manaku number of free water molecules higher ga unnai. Okay, right. Now whenever these two systems are placed, okay, side by side, right, well, then the net movement of water from system A to system B. Ippudu cheppandi mari. So water movement from, water movement is takes place from system A to system B according to water potential gradient, according to water potential gradient. Okay, so that's why diffusion of water is very high, in which DPD is very high, less reduction in the movement of water, but in which DPD is low, DPD is low due to the presence of more solute particles. Okay, na? Simple ga cheppalante DPD is equivalent to water potential. Okay, na? Right, meer ilaagu note chesukochu nana. So DPD is equal to OP minus TP. OP minus TP. Meer ee formula use chestu ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కూడా ఆన్సర్ చేయొచ్చు. ఓకేనా? రైట్. సో రైట్ అవుట్, వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్, వాటర్ మూమెంట్ ఈస్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్, వాటర్ మూమెంట్ ఈస్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ బిట్వీన్ ద సెల్స్, బిట్వీన్ ద సెల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ low DPD to high DPD. Very very important. From low DPD to high DPD. Okay, write down. So DPD is also known as suction pressure. So దీనిని సక్షన్ ప్రెజర్ అని కూడా అంటారు, ఎస్పి, అబ్రివేటెడ్ యాజ్ ఎస్పి. ఇది అడిషనల్ కాన్సెప్ట్. మీకు డిపిడి వాల్యూ ఏ సెల్ అయితే లోయర్ గా ఉంటుందో, ఓకే, ఫ్రమ్ దట్ సెల్ వాటర్ మూవ్స్ ఇన్ టు అనదర్ సెల్ విత్ హై డిపిడి. హై డిపిడి ఉన్నటువంటి సెల్లేకి వాటర్ మూవ్మెంట్ ఉంటుంది. ఓకేనా? సో ఇట్ ఇస్ వెరీ క్లియర్. నెక్స్ట్ imbibition, next topic. So another very very important topic, imbibition. Imbibition very very important. Okay, so imbibition is a special kind of diffusion, a special kind of diffusion. Note this point. It is also diffusion, but a special kind of diffusion. Okay, so what happens in this process? Listen to me. Water is absorbed by, water is absorbed by solid colloidal substances, solid and colloidal substances. Okay, so water is absorbed by solid and colloidal substances. So these substances are hydrophilic molecules or substances. So hydrophilic substances or hydrophilic molecules. So what is meant by hydrophilic molecules? These molecules exhibit affinity to the water. Affinity to the water. Okay, right. So whenever they absorb water, they show enormous increase in the volume. Okay, best examples of materials such as dry seeds and dry wood. Okay, so these are the classical examples. They show imbibition. Okay, for example, take the seed. So almost no water in the seed. So this is the seed coat. Okay, now it absorbs water. It absorbs water and becomes more and more swell. This process is called as imbibition. Listen to me carefully. Dry seeds or dry wood, almost they have no water. So that is the reason they absorb water and increase in the volume. Baga swell avutai. Okay, this process is known as imbibition. Okay, listen to me carefully. What is the imbibition pressure? Write down. Imbibitional pressure. So what is meant by imbibitional pressure? Listen to me carefully. This is the wooden piece, dry wood. Okay, on wetting, it absorbs water and becomes more and more swell. So it gets more and more swell. So due to the swelling of wood, okay, internally it has more pressure. So which is called as imbibitional pressure. Okay, right out. So imbibitional pressure, nothing but a pressure which is exerted by dry materials like such as seeds or wood. Okay, so that is imbibitional pressure. Okay, and actually prehistoric man, I mean in ancient times, for example, this is the rock. So this is the stone or rock. So this is the crevice in the stone. Okay, so prehistoric man, he placed dry wooden piece into the crevice. Okay, right. On wetting, it absorbs water and becomes more and more swell, and it exhibits imbibitional pressure. Okay, it exerts pressure on the stone. That's why stone or rocks or boulders are broken down, breaks off. Okay, na? So prehistoric man anedi ee imbibitional process nu use chestunto ee stones ni gaani boulders ni gaani ivini break cheyadam anedi chesaru. Okay, na? Right. So idu okati mana observe cheyochu. Actually it can be seen in a house, mana houses lo kuda chudochu. Okay, especially wooden frames around the window. Okay, during the rainy season, such wooden material which is present around the window, okay, as a frame, okay, it absorbs water and becomes more and more swell. Okay, that is the reason, due to imbibitional pressure, wall, it gets cracks. So walls mean andu kuda cracks vastai. Okay, so that is imbibitional pressure. Okay, right. So very, very important. So let us discuss another point, very, very important. So different types of substances exhibit different types of so different types of substances exhibit imbibition differently. For example, take the organic substance, that is protein, very very important. So protein, it exhibits high imbibition. Okay, so when compared to proteins, carbohydrates, okay, it exhibits low imbibition. Low imbibition. Okay, right. Right. So, ఇప్పుడు మీరు బేస్డ్ అపాన్ ద సో ఓకే ఇంబిబిషన్ సో అసెండింగ్ అని నోట్ చేసుకోండి. సో లీస్ట్ ఇంబిబిషన్ కెపాసిటీ ఫర్ సెల్యులోస్ హ్యావ్ లో ఇంబిబిషన్ కెపాసిటీ వెన్ కంపేర్ టు సెల్యులోస్ స్టార్చ్. Okay, so proteins have more imbibition capacity. Okay na, andike meer okada observe cheyalana. So starch, best example of wheat. So wheat grain iskondi, wheat grain. Okay, so proteins ku vachese example pea or groundnut example iskondi. Okay, so put the two seeds, wheat grains and pea seeds, in the water for overnight. Okay, meeru water teesukoni, so this is the wheat grain, this is the pea seed. Okay, tell me, pea seeds are present, pea seeds are characterized by the presence of proteins, whereas wheat, which is characterized by the presence of starch. Okay, so when compared to starch, proteins have high imbibing capacity. That's why proteinaceous pea seeds get more swell when compared to starchy grains. Okay na, starchy grains kante proteinaceous seed undi kada, okay, it gets more swell. Okay na, right. So that is the very very important point. Next one, listen to me. So diffusion a kind of imbibition a kind of diffusion ani cheppan kada. So here the movement of water molecules according to concentration gradient. Okay, so that means seeds are wooden material, wooden pieces have no water almost. Okay, right. So these are the two conditions. Number one, write down, water potential gradient is necessary between absorbent and liquid. So liquid which is imbibed, and not only water, any liquid. Okay, so water potential gradient is necessary between adsorbent, that is the material, and liquid which is imbibed. Okay, so in between, water potential gradient is compulsory. Next, and also very very important, affinity. Write down. So affinity between adsorbent and liquid is also prerequisite. It is also compulsory. Affinity between adsorbent and liquid also compulsory. Okay na? And so that means any substance in any liquid, okay, it exhibits imbibition, but which is based upon, which depends upon affinity. So ee affinity ki meer example teeskovali anukunte chunnana seed or dry materials, so dry wood, so which are imbibed in water, not organic solution, okay. So as well as rubber, so this is the substance, okay, it undergoes imbibition in organic solution, not in the water. Yes, affinity between adsorbent and liquid is very very important, okay, character. So ikkada meer observe chesthe kada, seeds in water, rubber in organic solution, okay, so they undergo imbibition. It ikkada meer inkodi kuda observe cheyandi na, so seeds, they undergo imbibition, okay, then only so they becomes more and more swell, right? So during the imbibition, seed, it gets more and more swell, and which is responsible for the rupturing of soil, then only seedling is established, okay. So seed, it germinates and produces young plant body, and ikkada opening of soil jaragalana and seed germination, okay, which depend upon imbibition, okay, at the time of imbibition seeds absorb water and become more and more swell, and which is responsible for opening of soil, okay. As a result of this, establishment of seedling is takes place, so seeds germinate kavalana imbibition jaragali, okay. So this is the process, okay, finally note chesukonma. So imbibition, which one is responsible for imbibition? Matrix potential. So deen pena depend ayi untund anamata, okay na, right? So it is very clear. In the next class we will discuss long distance transport systems for the movement of substances for long distance, okay. So we'll discuss in the next class.